Hi, it's Katrina. From an ancient shark attack victim from thousands of years ago to a skull with something very strange found in its mouth, here are 10 of some of the most mysterious and shocking archaeological discoveries. Number 10. New Egyptian Tomb. Archaeologists have announced the discovery of a tomb full of what looked like hundreds of spooky dolls. The new tomb was found in Luxor's West Bank at the Dra Abul Naga Necropolis. According to information from the Egyptian Ministry of Antiquities, the tomb dates back to the 18th dynasty and is one of the largest burial sites in the area. But what looks like dolls to us are not dolls at all, but Ushabti statues. The tomb is pretty unique, full of 365 Ushabti statues left inside the man's tomb. Ushabti statues were carved into the likeness of mummies, usually mummified humans with their arms crossed over their chests. Each one was carefully crafted by hand, and there were 365 placed into a person's tomb, representing each day of the year. Each Ushabti was able to come to life, one per day, to help the deceased in whatever tasks they were required to do in the afterlife. Many of these figurines were decorated with agricultural implements, since the Egyptians thought even in death, you had to keep on farming for your food. Only when dead, the statues would come to life and do it for you. It's not clear exactly who was buried in this tomb or why they deserved so many magical servants in the afterlife. Another coffin found here was carved in the shape of a person dating back to the 17th dynasty. Inside the coffin was the mummy of a 15 or 16-year-old girl resting on her side, wearing earrings, many beaded necklaces, and some other jewelry. Someone took the time to try to carve her face into the lid, but it's probably not really what she looked like. Nearby were some sandals that were incredibly well-preserved for being 3,600 years old. As the excavations continue at the necropolis, archaeologists are hopeful they'll find even more tombs to lure tourists back to Egypt and solve some of the mysteries of Dra Abul Naga. Number 9. Ritual Burials. 26 skeletons have been found in southern England, and they are creeping out the local archaeologists. Well, I don't know. They kind of like that stuff. It all happened while a new water pipeline was being excavated. Nobody had anticipated ancient burial pits to interrupt the city work. So far, the oldest of the burials has been dated back 3,000 years. While archaeologists can't say for sure who was buried here, they did say that there could be a connection between these 26 skeletons and the ancient people who built hill forts in the area thousands of years ago. The same people who carved the 360-foot figure known as the Uffington White Horse into a nearby hillside. The white horse was made from chalk, carved in the top of the hill in the shape of a horse thousands of years ago by an unidentified group of humans. But things get creepier as we dig deeper into the burials. Neil Holbrook from the Cotswold Archaeology team said the graves look suspiciously like other burial pits found from the Iron Age that were used in primitive sacrifices. Plus, archaeologists also uncovered the remains of dwellings, ancient tools, and scraps of pottery. Some of the archaeologists believe the pits here were used in ritual burials, probably with sacrificed humans and possibly animals. Unfortunately, even though the local experts suspect ritual burials, they don't really know what the rituals were. Many of the ancient people who lived in what is today the United Kingdom practiced sacrifices, but scientists don't actually know why they were so fixated on offering living people to their gods. Number 8. The Dismembered. The disturbing remains of a young child have been puzzling experts for over 100 years. It's not the remains themselves that are so mysterious, but rather the strange markings that were found on them. On the jaw of a child who was only 5 years old when they died, scientists identified strange markings that suggest either cannibalism or ritualistic activity. The skeleton of the young boy was found in El Castillo Cave, which is part of the Altamira Caves in Spain, the place in Europe with some of the oldest proof of humanity, as well as some of the oldest prehistoric cave paintings. German paleontologist Hugo Obermeier and his team found the jawbone in 1912, but they didn't give it much thought. The First World War broke out, and it ended up being stuck in a museum collection. It was lent out to another museum and then lost, until a team of researchers tracked it down. The indentations identified on the bone show that something bad happened to this child. In the cave near where the child was found, the team had also found small fragments of a cranium and the teeth of two other people. The analysis of the child's bones suggests he was a Homo sapiens, though with more primitive features such as bigger teeth and a smaller chin. The child's tongue was removed after death with some sharp implement, so archaeologists have been trying to figure out why. At that time, there was no shortage of food, so why would they want to eat him? It is the only clear case of this practice anywhere in Western Europe. Was it part of some spooky cannibal ritual, or was there something even more nefarious going on in Spain 27,000 years ago? Number 7. Skeletons at the beach. On the coast of Wales in the United Kingdom, a storm unveiled something very spooky. It all began in 2014 during a series of brutal storms. The locals started noticing that there were pale bones sticking out of the sand on the beach. As this went on, it became clear that there were hundreds of skeletons hidden right beneath their feet. For decades, the locals had been walking over a literal burial ground, with their kids playing in the sand and nobody the wiser. Once it was confirmed that the beach was riddled with the corpses of the dead, archaeologists were called in to deal with the situation. Archaeologists found not just a few dozen, but a couple hundred skeletons dating back to the medieval era. Excavations were done in 2014, and then every year until 2021. Archaeologists are now confident enough to say that on the beach here between the 8th and 11th centuries, there was a Christian community. They lived right here on the shore and were apparently burying their dead behind their local cemetery, which in modern times turned out to be a popular family beach. In total, 210 burials have been found so far. However, there was an unusual lack of artifacts. A few pieces of amber, a couple of pins, but nothing really noteworthy. There was also a large number of female and infant burials, over half, though archaeologists can't say why. They also don't know what happened to the seaside village that had an overwhelming female death rate. Number 6. Shark attack victim. The victim of a shark attack was recently discovered thanks to researchers from Oxford University. But this guy wasn't attacked by a shark while surfing in Australia or Florida. Instead, he was brutally killed by a shark 3,000 years ago while swimming off the coast of Japan. His body is the earliest evidence of a shark attacking a human. Through painstaking research, the international team of scientists was able to recreate the exact situation that caused this poor guy's violent death. The discovery came about while the researchers were investigating violent trauma on prehistoric hunter-gatherers stored at the Kyoto University in Japan. These are remains that have been dug up from ancient sites over the past century or so. They came upon one guy riddled with very obvious injuries, and researchers knew immediately that he must have been attacked by a shark. He had what the researchers called serrated injuries, approximately 790 of them. He had been gnawed on pretty good by the shark, then buried at the Tsukumo Shell Cemetery site with other people from his tribe. After the investigation, the team concluded that this guy died sometime around 1370 BC and was alive when he was attacked. They even found that his left hand had been sheared off completely, probably as he tried to fight the beast away. He was also missing his right and left leg, which were buried on top of his body. However, scientists don't know if he was actually out hunting for sharks and got killed by one, or if he just happened to be going for a swim. And now for number 5. But first, big shout out to Siobhan Williams from New Zealand and Barbara Sheena. Thanks so much to both of you for watching and supporting Origins Explain. We wouldn't be here without you. Be sure to hit that subscribe button if you are new here for more videos like these. Number 5. Satanic symbols. Archaeologists investigating the ruins of Ostia Antica near Rome made a very unpleasant discovery when they stumbled upon some satanic symbols. The excavation was led by a team of American and Canadian experts searching the ruins of a Roman home, one that likely belonged to a prominent member of society. It dates back to the 4th century AD and is located near an old mausoleum which is also 2,000 years old. But that doesn't mean that the symbols are that old. The archaeological site was closed for the winter. When they arrived in the summer to reopen the dig, they found that a group of vandals had shown up and scrawled satanic messages all over the ruins. Things like 666 were carved into the ancient stone, not only ruining the archaeological value of the structure, but also freaking out the archaeologists. Even more bizarre is that the ruins were littered with feathers from birds and leftover bonfires. The archaeologists are pretty sure that while the site was closed, a group of local Satan worshippers took it over and used it for their rituals. It's not clear if they actually tried to summon the devil or some other demons, but they were definitely up to something, and it involved sacrificing dozens of birds. Number 4. Bird skull in the mouth. Speaking of birds, the skeleton of a child with something very strange in its mouth was recently found in a cave in Poland. The skull of a small bird was found inside the child's mouth, a chaffinch bird to be exact, and another one right beside the child's cheek. Anthropologists haven't been able to figure out why the child was left in such a spooky condition after dying several hundred years ago. The discovery was made in Tunnelvelki cave. The kid was buried all alone. The only other human remains found inside the cave were dated to around 4,500 years old, significantly older than the bones of the child. This suggests that the cave wasn't really used for burials. The child is also the only modern human found buried in a cave anywhere in the region. This would be a pretty big mystery on its own, but it gets even more bizarre when taking into consideration archaeologists extracted the skull of a small bird from the child's mouth. What could this possibly mean? We don't really have an answer. According to Science Alert, radiocarbon dating has placed the death of the child sometime in the late 18th century, around 300 years ago. They died at the young age of 10, though they had been suffering from extreme malnutrition before their death. This is as far as it goes in terms of solving the case, as the bird head, the lonely burial, and all the rest is still a hopelessly creepy mystery. Number 3. Sacred chickens. Experts have come to a rather weird conclusion having to do with ancient chickens in Britain. According to a new study, researchers have shown that ancient chickens lived much longer than modern chickens. Why? Because our ancient ancestors thought chickens were sacred. They never thought of these small birds as food, but rather as animals to be revered. But it wasn't all fun and games. During the Iron Age, chickens were kept alive to be ritually sacrificed or to prove their worth in the cockfighting arena. For some strange reason, nobody thought about using them for food or even to produce eggs. Research has shown that today, the average chicken in the United Kingdom lives for between 33 and 81 days. But during the Iron Age, during the Roman occupation, and even into the more recent Saxon period, chickens lived to be up to 4 years old. The results came from testing 123 dead chickens found buried throughout the United Kingdom. Almost none of them showed evidence of butchery, and almost all of them were buried as complete skeletons, the same way a person would be buried. But as for why the ancient people of Britain thought chickens were sacred, well, that's a mystery nobody has managed to solve. Number 2. Twin Viking babies. Archaeologists have just discovered the remains of a pair of Viking babies, possibly twins, near the small town of Sigtuna in Sweden. These babies date back about 1,000 years. They were uncovered inside a tomb along with four adults and two other children. Researchers say this is some of the first evidence of a family Christian burial after the Vikings were converted to the new religion. Archaeologists know this because 1,000 years ago, it was a pretty turbulent time for religion in Europe. It's easy to tell today which religion a group followed based on how they were buried. For example, people who still followed the original beliefs of the Vikings were cremated. You've probably heard of a Viking burial, being pushed out to sea on a boat and lit on fire, or at least upon a funeral pyre. However, those who had converted to Christianity were buried on their backs. In addition to the Viking babies, coal deposits were also found, as well as some scraps of burned coffins. This suggests the Vikings weren't quite done with their pyromaniac ways of life, but had managed to incorporate fire with the Christian burials. Number 1. The world's oldest ritual. One of the most startling archaeological discoveries of the last few years involves the oldest ritual in the world. Professor Sheila Colson from the University of Oslo has discovered evidence that Homo sapiens were performing rituals in Africa 70,000 years ago. The discovery came while the professor was studying the San people, a group of ancient humans still living in a remote part of Botswana. While investigating artifacts from the Stone Age in the hills of the Kalahari Desert, known as the Mountains of the Gods, Sheila found a small cave so secluded that it had barely been touched by anyone. Inside of this cave, she found a rock that had been carved into the shape of a python's head. According to her and her group of students, it looked exactly like a real python. Even the way the light reflected over the carved rock made it look as though the stone had snake skin. Sheila and her team decided to start digging directly in front of the snake's head. They quickly found artifacts that they later dated at 70,000 years old. They found spearheads, tools, and red-painted spear tips that had evidence of burning. All of these artifacts point to some kind of strange snake ritual, only 30,000 years earlier than any other ritual performed on Earth that scientists know about today. Thanks for watching! Which of these discoveries did you like the most? Which one did you think was the creepiest? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time. Bye!